Are you ready? TeamSpeak, what about TeamSpeak? I am in TeamSpeak. I'm in the lobby in TeamSpeak. We will go into some of the TeamSpeaks in a minute, but let me set the teams up. Let's set the scene. Right, who have we got? So, on the Radiant, who is Hugh, guys? Do we know? I'm guessing it is... Guys, do you know who's who? Yeah, I'm updating the team list. Chill out, man. I'm doing it. Who is who? Is this the... These are the Russian dudes. So, well, we know no one is no one. Solo is obviously Solo. So many pros is... Oh, I know that is. That's Uber. I'm pretty sure. True Believer, I guess, is always Wanna Fly. So I guess... Hugh. A process of elimination is Mag. Yep. Does that sound right, guys? Yep. Over on the side of the Dire, you've got EG Zai. And then you've got Arteezy. And then you've got S4. And then you've got Kuroki. And finally, 1437. Uber is about Ivan. Okay, I remember that. Uber is Ivan. Or Ivan. Right. I'm just going to go get myself a drink before we start, boys. Don't go anywhere. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back. Let's get ourselves ready to go. All right, we're giving everyone proper player tags. Okay, so EG Zai, EG Arteezy. Come on, we're going to try and... This is... we're reminiscing today. Alliance S4. Kuroki. What do we want to... Well, it's got to be Na'Vi, hasn't it? Na'Vi, Kuroki. 1437. What did he... What team did Theban used to play for? Was it Liquid? It was an international team. Was it LGD? LGD Int. Lena. LGD Int, 1437. And then we've got Mag. Let's just put some Russian teams in here. So you got Hellraiser's Mag. Always Wanna Fly. From Mouse. No one, of course, did used to play for Union Gaming before the breakup. And then Ivan. He used to be on EHO. Chinese Lab. And Solo, of course, can't be anything else. Rock's Kiss. There we go. So, teams are ready, boys. Are you ready? I'm ready. This is going to be a good game. Let me move this so you can see it. I always Wanna Fly. This name's a little bit too long for me to work with, I'm afraid. Okay. That's a good point, actually. Artur, let's give him a proper mention. Back to the team that time forgot. Kai P. Zeus. All right, guys, yeah, do you want to hear some of the team speak? Well, so I don't normally say much during the draft because I'm a professional caster. So let's go over to the visualization first. Let's go and listen to the Dire speak of Osu's All-Stars, a.k.a. Team Secret. Let's have a listen to what they have to say for this drafting stage.
Channel switch. Sound resumed.
Build is definitely divine or some shit. Okay, Abyssal so bad. Useless.
That Cypher bash, that would have been so cool.
Oh, Odapixel is in the channel.
And fuck that guy. I mean, there's no way Abyssal's item over like somebody like.
They got Zeus, huh?
Like Refresher. Like you just refresh shrapnels.
Does that even work?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
That's not.
Okay, close the door. I did.
Even Jackie Mouse double close Scotty Pill is worse than this fucking Abyssal.
Really? Is it worse?
Yeah, it is. That's game losing shit.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys.
Not open stream, Archie. Got lag.
Oh, wait, Zai, I can't hear you on TeamSpeak.
Yeah, because I was not using push to talk.
Just do a chat if you want to.
Okay, yeah, sorry, hold on.
Sound muted.
There we go, boys. That was the dire chat there. Arteezy professing his love for me through a very kind of narcissistic manner. Let's head over to the Radiant and prepare your Babel fishes, because we may be going knee-deep into Russian territory.
Channel switch. Sound resumed.
Потом набрали. Серьезно?
Меня пока смущает то, что это какая-то трипла в харде может быть.
Sound muted.
There we go. The Russians.
Channel switched.
Telling it as it is. Fantastic. S4, stop stream sniping, please, sir. Can we have a Reddit thread? I rate this controversy about 7 out of 7 Reddit threads, so, see you on the front page in the morning, Carl. Of those All Stars versus Vega Squadron, who have we got so far on each team? Hellraiser's Mag, Mouse, Always Wanna Fly, UG, No One, Ehome, Uber, Rock's Kiss, Solo, sorry, Ehome, Ivan. Over on the side, sorry, that was Vegas Squadron. Over on the side of Vosis All Star, we have got Hugh, aka Mag. No, wait, sorry. Oh, sorry, I'm losing it. Right. Alright, boys. Welcome to the Face It Pro League, the place where professional players go after their competitive career is over. And can I just have a shout out, actually? Thank you very much for the donation. I've got a message. Clickorama says, keep up the good work. Well, I wouldn't say good work, it's only 5 inches. But thank you very much for the £5, my friend. Nice caster. Fuck you, Twitch chat. Can we please have some nice... Can you just put pictures? I really like pictures. I can understand them. They're much more easier for me to enjoy than all these. RIP TI5. Mate, I'm going to TI5, whether you like it or not. I'm just going to go, I'm going to sneak in, you know. I'll sneak in. And it'll be great. Anyway, can we have some predictions, please? If you think that... the dire side are going to win, could you please put some baby rages into the chat? If you feel the Radiant side are going to win, can you please put some superpowers? We need some superpowers. That's what we need for the Radiant. Superpowers versus baby rage. Who's going to take this fight? Who's going to take this game, lads? What do we reckon? What do we reckon, boys? I'm going to update the chat name. It is going to be renamed... to Russian Mafia versus Turkish Boys. Okay, there's a lot of baby rage in the chat. There's a lot of superpowers as well. I think you're agreeing. This is going to be a close match. I mean, what are we thinking of the draft so far? You liking it? Liking it? Dazzle. Yeah, people in chat saying TeamSpeak's not working in Dota TV. Yeah, there's no way that I can get it to pick up TeamSpeak, I'm afraid, so... You're just gonna have to watch the stream, sucker!
Phantom Lancer.
All right. We'll head into CS's, yeah, before we kick off, if you want. Let's see what they've got to say over on the side of Turkish boys.
Sound resumed.
Channel switched. Sank in bottom. That's what he said.
Wait, what did you say?
Of course he's stupid.
We're bottom. Up like,
okay. With the bait?
Yeah.
Hey guys, I can pick Tuskar and Dazzle and run at you. Russian.
What's wrong with you? That was actually so unacceptable.
What?
Yeah, apologize.
Are you stupid?
Right now.
Alright, off to Reddit.
What the yarn?
Fucking Russian dumb fucks.
Sound muted.
And let's cut that off before our tour gets a little bit more racist. But that was the Radiant, the Dire side there with Team EG. Anyway, Vega versus Havost, Russian Mafia versus Turkish boys. right, fantastic, fan-fucking-tastic. Right, oh, Lee, wow. Let's see what the Russians have to say in response to this aggression.
Sound resume. Channel switched.
Поехали.
Я сапог беру.
Да, да, да.
Я тоже сапог хочу.
По-моему, мы 3 в 3. Вполне...
Ты ни другой не учитываешь, что я говорю 3 в 3, типа... Я против Бэйна не постою, там Бэйн оффлейн.
Sound muted. Channel switched.
There they are anticipating the Bane offlane here, and they're going to be absolutely right. Zai on the offlane Bane seems to be what they're opting for on the side of the Dire. Anyway, so let me get the let me start recording on OBS just in case I actually ever get around to uploading these VODs. Oh wait, we're already recording. Shit. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, we've got that all on candid. Welcome to the game between the Russian Mafia and Turkish boys on the side of... Let me get this over here. On the side of Russian Mafia, we're going to have Mag. He is going to be playing on the Night Stalker. You're going to have Always Want to Fly on the Dazzle. It's going to be no one on the Zeus. It is going to be Ivan on that Troll Warlord in solo on the Tusk. Over on the side of Turkish boys, it's going to be Zai on the Bane. You're going to have RTZ on his PL, S4 on the Lina. Kuroki will be manning up on the Sanking, and 1437 on the Shadow Demon. Right, and the game begins. Here comes the snowball, as Artur predicted. Running in your face, it's going to work this time because Senpai... Oh, the Nightmare Deny! Oh my goodness! They're turning it around, the Russian Mafia! They've got their bags and they're packing out of here! First blood by Zai with the Nightmare. They're going to find more. That's your second kill of the game. Suddenly, the Russian Mafia, they're not going to be coming to Turkey anytime soon. Bane, he's going to protectively defend the Zeus from Karl, and that's another kill now. It's a 3-for-2 so far. They find two in return. They are going to be able to get the no one on the Zeus as well. Potentially he's looking for the die, he's looking for the deny, he's not gonna find a triple kill. It's a fucking triple kill. It's a triple kill. It's a fucking triple kill. Ladies and gentlemen, can I just say Zai offlane bane. I want to give a shout out to all the haters at the offlane Bane. Zai motherfucking triple kill, ladies and gentlemen, here on the Face It Pro League. Can you believe it? Can you, Adam? It's someone make a Reddit thread. Screw that. Make a whole bloody new subreddit. Bazaar. The triple killing offlane Bane. Wow. Wow. Fantastic. Fantastic. Let's go. Right. In the mid lane, we've got no one on the Zeus. Up against S4. 4-0 on the Zeus so far. 1-1 on Karl. Down in the bottom lane, it's going to be Bane. He's going to have the backup of Shadow Demon. They're going to be up against this Tusk Troll Warlord situation. Bane, of course, with the Enfeeble, going to make it very hard for the Troll Warlord to farm, putting him down to 49 minus 30 in range form. 19 CS. That's some techie level shit. Top lane, Phantom Lancer versus the Night Stalker. My goodness. It's what a game we've got on our hands. Let's see how the game goes underway. Bottom lane. So they've got this trial in here. At the moment, Dazzle making the pulls. 4-2 so far, favouring the side of the Dire. And Artur, he's left on his own for the time being. Sand King heading towards the jungle. Going to be looking to make those stacks for himself. And Karl harassing back Zeus here in the mid lane. Shadow Demon Bane, I'm at level 2. Is the killing potential there? They've got the Nightmare, they've got the Disruption. So a lot of defensive capabilities in the sense that when they see the Snowball go on someone, they're always going to be able to protect the other person. Straight in, Light Strike Array on to Zeus. There is enough mana for the follow-up Fiery Dragon Slave. He's trying to find the Bolt Charges to get it. Arc Lightning will cancel that. Oh, here comes your rotation solo. He's got a Haste Rune. He's got Snowball as well to go. Karl could be in trouble. He has got the Light Strike Array. Tried to preemptively do it. Won't be able to get the cast out. Zeus there with a final touch onto Lina, finding a kill now, 3-4. The Russian Mafia getting themselves back into the groove. Top lane, Night Stalker, the off lane NS. This is, of course, Mag himself playing this one. 9-1 as well, against the 13-4 on the PL. I mean, it's a lane where they're both farming in terms of harassing each other. Seems to be that they're just getting on and keeping up with it all. Three minutes in. Troll? I mean, looking at the drafts, you've got this Troll, you've got this PL. We were talking yesterday with Wagamama about how the PL essentially is very, very strong against the Troll. As soon as it gets to man fighting with the illusions, with the doppelganger to remove the Misty buff, and the fact that, obviously, as a hero, you can only get that debuff applied once. So you can doppelganger... You're not doppelbanging anyone on this stream, but you can doppelganger, remove it, and return to the fight and not be, not, you don't have to worry about having it on yourself again. Troll's farm, it's all right, but it's not as good as the Lina. S4's in the mid lane and PL in the safe lane. Four minutes in the jungle though. Ice Shards onto Bane, puts the Nightmare onto Dazzle, trying to save himself for a little bit. The Enfeeble onto Tusk, being a little bit of an issue. Now it's just Snowball forward, Troll coming in as well, but the Disruption. I told you about these guys defensively being able to save each other kind of infinitely, and it's working out. Bane's going to be able to back up. Zai with the Bottle Charges, he's fine. And these guys just can't find the kills. Tranquil's now a Night Stalker. It's going to be able to provide him a little bit more survivability in lane. No boots yet on the PL. Poor man's shield into the Band of Elven skin, and still has a salve on himself. Snowball in on the bottom lane. It's a little bit too deep for the rest of the team to join in. Zeus got himself an Invis rune. Both heroes about to hit level 6. And this mid lane, 4.5 minutes in. Still PL, having a great time in this solo lane. The Night Stalker really hasn't been able to do that much to slow down Artur's farm. And he realizes that. He's in no threat at all. He has the one point in doppelganger if he needs to get out in an emergency. But still, no boots. Wraith Band and Band of Elves get bottom lane. Sorry. They dive deep, and this time they will be able to find the Bane. Shadow Demon out of mana. Out of health, luck and health as well. Can't really go back into this one. Stays defensively behind it. 4-4 at the moment. 5 minutes in. It's like a very, very close game between these two sides. Yeah. It's heading around the 0 point. Who is going to come out on top? I mean, you've got to favor the PL in the late game. But then, it kind of feels like the Radiant side, if they're able to kind of pull off this early aggression, it's going to be quite hard for the side of the Dire to come back from. But at the same time, if the game goes on, you can never doubt Artur's farming capabilities and his ability to fight and be very aggressive. And PL, arguably, once you get that defusal, he's up there with the PA in terms of fighting potential. Right, Zai is going to be able to pull up himself a rune. A haste or an invis would be nice. Well, top lane, Artur, he's going for more. Night Stalker says, ah, you're on my side of the map, but Artur says, sup, buddy? And goes for the kill here. The Karl S4 will come in. Mag tries to get a void off, but it will be a kill. Looks like at the same time, was it the Thundergod's Wrath? It was, no, yeah, it was the Dazzle going in on the Bane. Thundergod's Wrath did help out, but Bane lost his life. But all in all, it's a trade that does favor the Radiant. Getting that kill on the offlane NS and getting S4 and Artur involved. And now in the mid lane, Laguna Blade straight onto the back of Tusk. That's one kill. Make that two. Double kill here for S4 with this double damage in the mid lane. All in all, very nice bit of action here for the Dire. And here we go, the facts from Jonky PMNZ. S4 has never played Lina in competitive Dota. His last pub game as Lina, he goes for 6 drums. Let's see if we see the 6 drum build come out this game from S4. But interesting to note that he's never done it in competitive. So far, he's having a pretty good start. 3 kills, 4 assists. 7 minutes in. The mid lane Lina has been involved in every kill that your team's got. Top lane, they want to try and go for the kill here. They've got the Crippling Fear. They'll go straight in with it. There's your Void as well. Is the silence long enough to find the kill? It is nighttime, so it should be. Oh, he gets the doppelganger off. Look at this player. Lightning Bolt's going to miss. He's going to go for the TP. He won't find it, though. Arc Lightning is able to secure the kill. Artur nearly getting away with a lot of BS there in that situation. Troll having a lot of fun with the Enfeeble. Bane has a bash there. 7-7 at the moment. Lina's got the treads complete, 900 gold as well on top of that. Rotation now coming on to Bane solo, but I mean, is there the damage for these two heroes to find the kill? They do have battle chance, they're going to certainly go for it. Defensive nightmare, now comes the TP from the ban on the Shadow Demon. Now with the disruption of the poison, let me try to turn around a little bit. So many pros coming in, but he's been enfeebled. 81 right-click damage, it's not the worst. Well, it is 30 less than what he was hoping for. Bane being denied the invis there for the time being by the ice shards. We'll be able to grab it now. Secret. Hello. Sorry, Kuroki. 8-minute blink dagger. Why the hell not? He's a little bit short, though. And also, that barrow strike wasn't long enough to get there. 8-7. He will pay with his life. And that was a little bit of an unfortunate reveal of the blink dagger there. Wasn't able to achieve anything for the team. Does end up giving away his life. Still, though, space created for Artur. Artur still at the top of the CS. If we have a look at the net worth as well, 4k gold on the Lina at the moment. S4 at the top, followed by the Zeus and the Troll. Surprisingly though, well, I guess with the jungle farm, yeah. Kuroki's got more farm than this Artur PL. Bottom lane, they're going in for a kill on Bane. Crippling Fear's there. Oh, the defensive nightmare. He takes it off, though, with a Brain Sap. There's your disruption as well. The combination of skills here. Now they're going to be able to try and turn it around. Void will come out for Night Stalker. He is able to find the Bane. Ice Shards being thrown out. They do have a Snowball. They could maybe try and turn this. Here we go. Kuroki burrowing forward, finds the stun and the kill onto Dazzle. Shadow Poison going down onto Night Stalker. One more stack will be able to find the kill. And maybe they can look for more. Now's the Snowball. Lightning Bolt coming through from no one on the Zeus who's rotated in. No, it looks like we're going to see the death of the Shadow Demon. We might as well see Kuroki go down. He looks for a final burrow strike, but it will be a double kill to the Zeus. 11-9. Two heroes down on both sides. S4 coming in, but just a little bit too late. Has got the Laguna Blade. Stick charges popped by Tusk. He's got the Snowball, he's got the Ice Shards, the Snowball to dodge the Light Strike Array. There goes your Ice Shards to try and block him out, but Karl will be able to walk around. There's Zai going in with the Fiend's Grip onto Zeus. There is a Shallow Grave available, it'll be there just in time. The Light Strike Array and the punches, is it going to be enough to find the kill on Zeus? There's your Laguna Blade onto the Tusk. They've managed to keep both alive. Nightmare holding Dazzle back, meaning that you can't get another heal out. So Zeus and Tusk both fall. Now Dazzle's going to be the one to pay off his life as well as he jukes around the trees. It's not enough. Triple kill here for S4 on the Lina. Bane. Zai coming out with the plays perfectly, and Lina, Karl has the damage to offer up. 12-11. And still Artur farming on this top lane. Boots Aquila, Ban of Elven Skin. Has the poor man's shield. 1,200, 1,300 gold coming around the corner as well. Now Shadow Demon trying to find some levels in the lane. Courier. What's it got coming out? I was working to Karl's Yule Scepter. Karl at the moment, there we go. TP's in. Just wanted to hold him for the time being. I'm 10 minutes in. Let's have a look how the graphs are looking, ladies and gentlemen. XP-wise, over 3k. Gold-wise, it's over. It's coming up to 5k, boys. Smoke up now. 1437 and S4. The light one up. I'm going to be able to find anything that's with that, though. They're going to just back up to their own side. Lena, Carl, just pushing down on the tier one. Look at all these smokes being buying. I mean, come on, I know you guys are rushing, but... think of your health. 11 and a half minutes in. Still smoked up. Shadow Demon. Bane, Zai, baiting on the front lines. Very passive bit of the game at the moment. Smoke up potentially from the Radiant. There we go. Mag popping the smoke there on the NS. They're all going. They're leaving Zeus at the moment in the mid lane. Zeus hasn't got the Thunder God's Wrath to offer as well for this rotation. Still 40 seconds before that's back. So they're just going to check out Roche. Gets the ward down above the pit. And now they'll head back into the Dire jungle. Sorry, the Radiant jungle. This could be a good kill here for the Russian Mafia. They could take a quick hit against the Turkish boys. Carl, Kuroki, in we go. Nightstalker waltzing in. Sandstorm straight away. Burrow Strike as well. Lightstrike away. They might be able to turn it around and find a kill. No, the Shallow Grave. Absolutely clutch there from True Believer. They'll turn it around. Boris Punch onto S4. They find the kill. Kuroki will be able to TP out, but a very nice rotation and smoke use there from the Radiant. 12 to 12 on the board. This is going to be a... we've got a game on our hands. And towards the mid lane. Zeus has the Blink Dagger. Sol Ring. Night Stalker. Tranquils. And the Urn. Troll with the Face Boots. Morbid Mask. Yasha now as well. Troll is going to become an issue very, very quickly. Still S4 sitting at the top of that net worth. PL, Artur hasn't really been involved in the fights. Just continues to try and climb himself up that board. Just behind the Troll at the moment in terms of farm. Senpai, 1437. Looks like all that smoking's gone to his head. A little bit out of place there. Did have a ward on him, maybe trying to get lane ward down. Isn't even able to do so. And Theban will go down for the count. 13 to 12. Mid lane Zai. Level 8. He's going to get Ice Shards. In comes your Snowball as well. Tries to look for the cast with the Nightmare. We'll finally get it off. But there's your Lightning Bolt to finish off the kill. Kuroki popping the Epicenter. Isn't going to want to jump into that though. With the Bane already being down. Soaring now for the Sand King. Just to ensure that he's always going to be able to get off that Sandstorm. In the nick of time. Well, I guess just for the extra Burrow Strike to be fair in the fight. And ooh, solo. Come on, let's try not to build a reputation for yourself, my friend. Burrow Strike, Laguna Blade walks into three of the side of the Turks. 14-13. Wizard Travel now in Artur. He wants to farm, and he's going to be able to step it up. Zeus working on the Aghanims. He's got the blink, he's got the point booster. 400 gold in the bank as well. One lane troll. Still pretty much uninterrupted farm. Working towards the SMY, has the Yasha Ogre Club on top. Let's have a look at the overall difference between the team's XP and net worth. It's very, very close, boys. Slightly favoring the Dire at the moment. About 2k gold and 2k net worth in it as well. Kuroki just continue to farm up the enemy jungle. We'll see what he decides to opt for next. And imagine the Veil is going to be the call. Bane picks up the robe, picks up the chainmail. What does it make? Blade mail. Smoke up now. from the Radiant. Night Stalker leading the way. He's only got a few seconds left of night time. So, you got to question the potential of this fight. Has got the ultimate, actually, so he's fine. Artur, he wants more, but so do they. Snowballs to the face of the PM, crippling fear as well. Defensive Nightmare is going to save him for some time, but the walrus punch to the backside. Artur thrown up into the air, will go down. Fiend's Grip onto the Night Stalker, but he's too damn tanky. Brain Sap onto the side of Dazzle. Now Senpai, 1437 on the Shadow Demon alongside Zai on this bane, trying to chase this down. Weave, though, ticking down the armor away. They could maybe try and turn this. At the same time, Blink 4 from S4, he's going to jewels up the Tusk. He might be able to find the kill. He will be able to with the Light Strike Raid, Laguna Blade to the face. They'll find a kill there. Nightstalker's able to TP out. And well, Zeus has got an Invis rune. Do they have any detection? It's going to be unlikely. No, he's going to be able to get himself out and away. So all in all, just this one-for-one trade. I was not actually showing the PL kill there, but PL did go down, of course, at the start of that fight. But S4, still the one to watch. 8.2k net worth on the lad. Treads and Blink Dagger and Jewels, 17 minutes in. Ping's coming out. He wants to get a solo kill. Why the hell not? Hasn't got the Laguna Blade, and will he be able to get the Shadow Grave off? Yes, he will. Now the backup's coming. S4, how greedy does he want to be? Does he want to try and go for this? He does. He might pay for his life as in comes Zeus, but no, the Light Strike Array. Car, the backup's here. Kuroki gets tag teamed in. In comes Zai as well with the Brain Sap. Two heroes down on the Radiant. S4, perfect judgment. Gets himself out A-OK. Troll does have the SNY now, though. Does have the SNY. Artur, he's getting there. He's working his way up. The young lad, he's doing his best. 7.5k net worth on him. On top of the piece of travel on the Yasha, working towards the Diffusal. He's picked up the recipe. He's not got the Blade of Alacrity, second Blade of Alacrity in the robe anyway, has he? No, he's still a Blade of Alacrity and a robe of Magi short. And S4 there will be able to grab himself a refreshers orb. And indeed, the Bane Blade Mail. It's of course now finished up by Zai. Right, it's an interesting one, why not? I mean, it's kind of working now. Well, there's your Snowball. Zai thinking of Nightmaring. Gets Ice Sharded in as well. Blade Mail gets popped. Brain Sap. Gonna top him up a little bit. Defensive Disruption, but he could be in a lot of trouble here as the entire team of the Radiant go ham. That's a kill there for the Troll. S4 getting low as the Blink forward by the Zeus. Oh, Ice Shards, unfortunately, not gonna trap the Lina. S4 will be able to get away. The same might not be said about Senpai here as he gets Crippling Feared. That will be okay. The nice Light Strike Array, but here's your Snowball. It's not going to quite be able to close the gap. Here we go, the Kuroki with the do-do-do. Two heroes down, double kill. They popped a Sentry Ward down. They do see him, though. Pops the one charges, trying to juke it out. He will go down. It's a 2-for-2 trade after the initial Bane kill. If you want to include that, it's a 2-for-3. So a very nice fight there for the Radiant. They'll be able to get the Tier 1 here as well. Top lane, though. Artur still focusing on the farm. He's about to close in on the penultimate Blade of Alacrity for his Diffusal. Playing a little bit with fire here. He knows that Zeus is down. There won't be any ultimate available. 18-18. Nightstalker. Mag. He's going to have a pretty good timing here on the Aghanims. Point boost to Ogre Club and Self of Wizardry. 700 gold away from the Blade of Alacrity as well. This is not bad timing at all for the old offlane NS. 20 minutes in. Dazzle has got the wand and the medallion so far. Let's have a look at the other cores over on the side of Secret. Kuroki working on his own force stuff. 150 gold away from picking that up. And there we go. So Artur now with the Diffusal Blade. We'll see if he does decide to focus on continuing to farm or looking for fights. The kind of build that he's opted for definitely weighs itself more towards the farming. With just the 1 point in Phantom Rush and the 1 in Doppelganger, shows he doesn't want to get involved in too much. Kuroki and S4, they want to get involved in something, though. They blow up the Night Stalker. Thundercross Wrath there from Zeus, revealing the Kuroki Sand King getting very low. Nice Burrow Strike, Light Strike away. The damage, it's not quite there to kill the Zeus off. Shallow Grave was available and is used. Sand King does pay for his life. Fiend's Greed onto the Tusk. Tusk will get blown up. This is a 2-for-2 trade so far. True Believer getting thrown up into the air. Doesn't have a secondary Shallow Grave to use. Light Strike Array. Carl, his armor's low. But Dazzle's luck is lower. 3-for-2 trade, and maybe they look for more, Troll. Can they chase this down? Artur trying to close the gap. Instead, he's going to opt to just focus on the mid lane, get this pressure on, and try and get this tier 1 down with the rest of his team. 21 to 20. If we look at that fight recap, 2-for-3. Favoring XP, it's only about 1k. I mean, it's still, it's very even this game. But the threat of the PL is growing bigger and bigger. And they do still maintain about this 4,000 XP and gold lead for the Dire side. Let's do S4 on this Lina. Having an absolute game. 11 kills, 3 deaths, 6 assists. Involved in 17 of the 21 kills that have happened on the board. You've got to give hats off to Zai as well. Really making this Bane pick work. And it's a pick that, you know, in Dream League, I talked to Andy about it a lot, Draskal. And he's surprised that we don't see it picked a lot more against heroes like the Troll. In lane, the Enfeeble's fantastic. And when it comes to the mid game, the amount of control that you have can be very, very annoying to deal with. 22-minute rune is going to be bottled up by Zai. Something nice, he says. Can you give me a haste rune or an invis? His prayer's not going to be answered. It's going to be his brother, 1437, picking up the invis rune on the bottom rune. Oh, TCPL. Well, here we go. Top of the net worth, and Troll's going to make something big happen here if he wants to try and get himself back on top. Killing this creep camp will be the answer. No, he's still just below, but what I'm trying to say is PL, he's going to get out of control. Oh, so someone needs to do something about the PL. They've killed him twice already in the early game, but still, it just feels like it's not enough. Now they go for Roshan. Straight into the pit. PL, not really the fastest person to do it, but I mean, he's got a hefty bit of damage on him now. There you go, S4 joins the party. And off that note, they should be able to do it. Are the side of the Radiant going to look to try and contest this? They don't have any vision around the pit. It looks like they're going to give up. In fact, well, S4. Hang on, was that? Okay, Nightmaring himself and taking it off. Why not, Zai says. Why not? Going for the Aghanims now on the Bane after the Blade Mail. Point boost to Ogre Club. We're now seeing the blink on the Tusk. So now, let's see if we can see some very clutch blink snowball defensive plays and offensive plays. Essentially, you know, a poor man's Shallow Grave gets himself in there next to someone like the Troll. Or anyone on his team. And he'll be able to save them. The Dire. All in the Radiant jungle at the moment. Arteezy joining the cause now. Maybe looking to try and take this tier 2. Radiant themselves, they're going for tier 2 in the mid lane. Carl, smoked up. It's going to get revealed though by the Thunder God's Wrath. Oh, the Radiant, they're very aware where the Dire are. They're just going to stick around in the mid lane. And we'll find this tier 2. PL, Artur. Knocking on their door. We'll find the kill. There's just Kuroki, Burrow Strike, Epicenter, Light Strike Array into Fire Dragon Slayer. They're already blown up too. Solo will throw himself into the snowball. The Drive Ball Stun gets the Kuroki and the Zeus. Sorry, not the Zeus. PL. Double kill for PL. Solo gets caught out by Light Strike Array. That's going to be another kill in the pocket of Team Secret. Three heroes down on Vega. Team Havorst. Looking pretty good. 25 to 20. They take the tier 2, they're straight in there with the defense. And I think after that fight, if we have a look at the difference between these two sides, yeah, it's starting to tip off very heavily towards Team of Voice. Coming up to 7.5k XP, gold-wise, just over. But still, it's not irrecoverable, and the side of Team Vega, they've got a Troll. They've got a Troll Warlord, boys, and if there's one thing you got to remember about Troll, he's pretty good. Right, they're going to be able to claim Roshan here. We'll go the way of Artur on the PL. 2.2k gold now on top of the Yasha top lane. Boots are traveling in. Going to help his buddy Zai take this tier 2. And the tier 2, sitting at only 185 HP. Will go down, Artur. Playing around with the attack. Animation cancel. Gets himself the last hit on the tower. Well, Dazzle. That Shallagrave, hats off to that. It won't be enough to keep himself alive. Oh, but what? The snowball? Hello. Hello, baby. Snowball. Going in. He's got a lot of armor as well. Maybe down. No. There we go. The magical damage from the Fiery Dragon Slave. It's enough. There goes Ref coming out. PL, he's going deep. Arthur wants to go hard. He has got the Aegis. War's Punch will bring him low, and he does lose the Aegis. Void from the Nightstalker. Nightstalker getting nightmared. Fiend's Grip onto the Zeus. Arthur coming in and help to find the kill onto the Zeus. Now he's going to look for the Troll. Diffusal Blade slow onto the Troll. Warlord pops the BKB. Now trying to manfire up against all of this. Is he going to be able to find any kind of kills? He's sitting fairly low, and yeah, the Troll's going to have to back himself out. 3-for-1 trade. Make it a 4-for-1 as they catch out. Hugh on the Nightstalker. Burrow Strike. Bane getting the final sickle into that tackle. 1-for-4. Again, Team Avost coming out very much on top of these fights. It's going to be all up to this high ground defense. Oh, Zeus. Hello? Zeus going straight in, blinks away. Yes. I want to be careful there, Zeus. Weave catching out Kuroki and Artur. Artur goes for the TP. Can't quite get in range to cancel it. 21-29. And on that bombshell, let's have a listen to what they are saying over in Team Havors, Team Speak.
Channel switch. Sound resume.
Right now. I'm gonna tip it there and push it out.
I actually need to get some words. Oh. 7 on the smoke on the crew.
They're either smoke. I thought there's smoke, but they're really farming this.
Yeah,
there's a golden.
Okay,
oh, they're coming.
He's just deorting. He might be alone, but whatever.
No, I think they're all behind him. They're on show. Yeah, they used like them.
He has X, right?
I don't know.
Rune spawning soon. We can stack.
Alright, I'm just gonna go back.
Nighttime, yes.
Like, ancient.
Yeah, they're like far top.
Yeah, he was alone bottom.
I'll stack this right here.
They're not gonna push because I think Zeus was like here, right? So
they're pretty strong.
Get
top. They have like.
I mean, Zeus can't get top, right?
No, I have bots and like I can bots in 10 seconds.
Nah, you can run top.
We glyph.
I'm running for top.
Nice, okay. Oh.
Zeus is mid.
Here. I'm gonna bot.
Wanna go, Zeus?
I might.
Yeah.
Go.
I'm Mike.
Sound muted.
Okay, so now the fight kicking off as we hear them. They were aware that the push was going to come in. They pop the fortification. Now Solo and Hugh straight onto Carl. Arteezy trying to fight up against Troll Warlord, who's popped the BKB. Zeus is already down. Lina, S4 has fallen though. And now with the illusions, they'll be able to hopefully find the Troll Warlord for all you secret fan gaze out there. 2-for-1 though. They've lost Shadow Demon. They might lose PL as well. The Russian aggression is paying off. 3 heroes down on the tide of Team Secret. And are they going to be able to find anything else? So Kuroki going in with the blink with the Epicenter trying to get an Ice Stalker, gets him low, but the defensive Ice Shards blocking Kuroki away from NS. Crippling Fear onto Bane. And that might be it though. The Russians, they're out of mana. They are going to back up out of this one. 3-for-1 trade there. Zai, blink forward. Hello, fist pumps the air there, Tusk. Bane and Sand King Kuroki will be able to walk away. Let's have a listen to what they have to say in reaction to that.
We're saying that we're going to go top.
No, but you have to look at the map. If they're saying they're going mid, we have to back top, right?
Well, I knew they were going mid. I thought they were split. I thought it was just Dazzle Troll.
I mean, it was my bad. Still.
I'm gonna TP bottom to farm the jungle. Someone can come.
We call that the farm.
I'm gonna go top.
I don't have grip yet.
I don't have ulti either. But I do have Dagon, which is quite good.
I can bot bottom 10.
On this. If I see someone, I'm gonna stun it. Oh, Zeus!
I'm not sure if I can go.
Go back.
Keeping bottom right now, actually. Keeping.
I couldn't blink.
Yeah, we can't go for these kills.
Yeah.
Someone needs to push out the lane.
Sound muted. Okay, and in favor of equality, let's hear what's going on the side of Team Vega.
Channel switched. Sound resumed.
Есть бот вон кто-то или нет?
У меня есть.
Если хочешь... А, ты далеко?
Я здесь.
Да я почему? Мелодер нормально, смотри,
да. Да я убиваю.
По принципу нормально.
Я убиваю иллюзии.
Иван, тебе потом это МКБ еще надо будет.
Что, да не хотим взять? Он один в миде сейчас. Один.
Можем реально Лина сверху.
Ультимейт есть.
Попа, надо быстрее замыть ждать.
Лина бежит. Я то буду
далеко. Мы можем
вообще можем на нее.
Гоза диварда. Гоза диварда.
Я постараюсь его сразу
будет меня скорее всего убивать. Будет сейф.
Нет, да. Нет, вот я далеко.
Что у меня?
Я... Да не, 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 нету. Юла. Она вверх ушла.
Она с даггером, она просто.
Она мало даггер тэп аут.
Вот она.
Вот она. Я на урну зацеплю. Блять.
Пол. Там внизу пэл.
Блэт is the word there as S4 with the Yule Scepter manages to get himself away. 30 to 26 at the moment between the Turkish and the Russian. God damn it. Anyway, let's have a look at the graphs. Look at that swing though, after those fights though. Team Avos losing a lot of the lead that they had. 14,000 now, down to a 4,000 XP lead. Now from about the 15,000 to the 9,000. They need to be careful, they're slipping a little bit. Can they turn around here? There's your snowball straight into Artur. Artur has to back out for the time being, but now your Fiend's Grip holding him through the BKB. He's out of mana, the Troll Wall, and he looks for a punch, but he actually gets Nightmared. Whoa, because he attacks the Nightmare Bane. Look at this. Bane and Artur are going to be able to get away. Nightmare onto Tusk. Very early Shallow Grave there for the Tusk. And Tusk has been left now. Solo. A little bit solo. They're trying to chase us down. Boroshite Kuroki, what a player. There you go. Sandstorm as well. And Brain Sap, Fiery Dragon Slave. Finish it off with a dag on there from Kuroki. What a kill. 31 to 26. Solo left all on his own there. Poor lad. Dazzle kind of just gave him an HL. Here you go, mate. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. You'll be golden. He wasn't. Trollwall is heading down. He's going to find himself an Invis Rune. Roshan not up for a few minutes. Now into the jungle. Artur needs to be a little bit wary here. Because there we go. Blink forward, Lightning Bolt. We'll be able to get the Doppelganger out. Taking a fair bit of damage. With the Talisman of Evasion, though, proving to be a bit of a difficult target here for the Trollwall. Lina, with yours, onto the SF. We'll be able to get the Light Striker Ray out. And well, they're going to blink out, and they're going to back out Vega. Now the push coming from the side of Team Havos. PL still at the top of that net worth, but Troll is keeping himself in there. He's keeping himself relevant. Maelstrom on the Troll. Not an item build that we see all the time, but we do see picked up, of course, against the PL. They need some kind of way to burst through these illusions, and the Maelstrom Lightning Procs is certainly going to be the answer to that. Well, at least to some extent. Top lane. Well, Bane says, reaches his arms out. Have a whiff of this. Zai, easiest kill of his life. 32 to 26. And, well, fight recap. A little bit of golden XP. It's still looking good for the side of the Dire, but there's one bad team fight and it'll be all over for the Radiant. Let's have a listen to the Dire's team chat and see how they're kind of approaching the game at this point.
Sound resumed. Channel switched.
Hey, spawner for Lina.
Yeah.
Spot night time. Gonna time it.
I don't know. I guess they're checking for Roshan.
Look, we still have a smoke and shop.
I have bots available in 15 seconds.
He now has another item sent too.
Yeah,
I'm thinking about
the Russian spawns.
Oh, it's up, okay.
Less
than 5 seconds.
I'm gonna bring some wards again.
I can tank it reliably now because of Butterfly.
Nice, it's dying.
Serious damage.
Oh, they're gonna scout this.
Yeah, I think coming. So too.
They're gonna drop this here.
Oh, so far away.
Close top. Let's go.
Can we push out this?
Night time is over in 5 seconds.
We got away. I have haste, so we can catch Funnel. Just troll it up.
Yeah, I'm gonna get that blink.
That's all.
I'm gonna get mid.
Still checking. Bots and just troll it up.
Gonna put smoke and Corey.
Sound muted.
There we go. So an easy Roshan there for the Dire side. And the Radiant just not in a position to do anything about it at the moment. They just head back, as Artis was saying, to clear out that mid lane. Zai. He's a little bit far out here. There's three heroes around. It looks like, well, they're scared. They just turn, they tuck their tails, and they run. I don't want to be running into this Bane. He has got the backup of the Lina, and S4 Lina is something that you do need to be very scared of indeed. 32 to 26. Level 2 Dagon on Kuroki. Double damage. It's been scouted out. Where's your PR when you need him? He's in the neighborhood. Butterfly complete on top of the Manta. And with the Dominator as well. Under God's Wrath being popped out. There's Troll, Warlord, and Dazzle just hold the fort in the mid lane. Solo. So working towards his BKB out in the bottom lane. Mithril Hammer, Ogre Club. Still 900 gold to go. Still seems to be a very, very stable part of the game. And chat, I know you want it, so let's have a listen to what Team Vega have to say about this situation that the game's currently in.
Channel switch. Sound resumed.
А, не, у меня... Ночь.
У нас на любой стадии игры Зевс будет хорошо разбираться с иллюзиями.
Да.
Медиа убьет.
А, убьет.
Так я...
Не-не-не. Элтра волнулся у меня.
Ну и откинуться у нас много чего.
Ну, без меня будете дефить.
Я хочу МКБ добить 300.
Добивай, нам надо как-то с поводов дефить.
Я ем, выкладываю.
Я закрываю ХГ пока просто.
Пау.
Буду держать.
Блин, это
не подави сейчас, меня увидели.
Okay, and let's have a look to see what the Dire say in this big, big push in the game.
Channel sound resume.
I earned you.
Keep heading.
Actually, don't.
Because it's us.
They don't have any initiation, so.
Can we kill the CJ?
Yeah, I'll go. My purge work.
That's a lot of damage. Alright, let's back.
I'm gonna go top.
Rune spawning.
They
will drop that.
I got a chase.
Yeah,
oh.
I get a 4 step for us now.
Take runes.
I'm leaving the other smoke on the carrier too.
Ooh.
Carrier's filled with shit.
I'm going back. Hold on 1 second, chicken.
3 bottom.
You wanna take smoke?
Demon.
I have one. I think we might use one soon. Darkness is gonna be over. We have 30 seconds to do something. And Su Salty is also gone. It's actually really good timing. If you go right now.
Yeah, we can
go
use
right
second.
Now. Go
do
right
you
now.
Have an urn?
No, I don't have an urn. No charges. But we can still.
We have bottle from Bane. He can bottle.
Is Pia botting in?
I can bot in you.
Well, not for the smoke. But only
yeah,
for
you don't know. Just come. Just TP and push.
Yeah.
We can find one. Darkness is over.
Top.
Hey, we got
reveal. I'm running. I'm stunning.
I was gripping.
He's BKB. Yeah.
I slapped the dazzle.
I'm gonna get the dazzle. I'll get dazzle.
Nice.
I got gem.
Those guys are not TP, by the way. Well, you push. I run. Okay, he's gonna get.
Blink to it. Back to still.
Okay, so there we see a couple of very nice pickoffs for the Dire Laguna Blade, with that Hags, of course, doing so much damage against these slither heroes like the Dazzle. And now the push is going to begin onto that mid lane, onto the Rax, and this is going to be the melee Rax down. Ranged Rax will quickly fall afterwards as well. So now a Rax advantage. Perhaps they can look to take some more here. Arteezy leading the charge onto the tier 3. There's no buyback for either the Dazzle or the Night Stalker. Kuroki four-staffing himself forward. BKB's popped by Solo and Troll Waller going out on the Bane. We'll be able to find the Bane. Now he's trying to work onto Kuroki. Kuroki will go down as well. It's a double kill here now for the Troll. Blink forward by Solo, trying to be able to control Artur. Artur going in on the Zeus. Will find the kill on the Zeus. Looks for the final axe though. Triple kill now for the Troll Warlord. Ice Shards, they're going to be able to trap Bane in. Now going over the Whirly Axes. He's looking for a bash. Blade Mail, what's it going to do for you now, Zai? Looking for the bash. There's the bash. He goes down as well. Zeus will find the kill though. Peeps the kill away from the Troll. Team Havorse maybe overextending a little bit too much there, because suddenly three heroes down. Zai on the decks for 90 seconds without buyback. Wow. Here comes the push. Monkey King Bar. 3.9k gold on the Troll. no Zai for this defense. They do still have the tier 2 remaining, and they do have a fortification as well. S4. He needs to be careful about coming around the back here. He's on his own. Where's Artur at? Artur at Rat. He's literally trying to push down and counter push this. But can a PL out push a Troll? We're about to find out. Troll straight onto the tier 3s. Tier 3 goes down. And now they look for more. Nightstalker pops the nighttime. Ready to go in. Fortification now from the Dire. And there we go, straight in. The racks to fall. Senpai, 1437, secret Kuroki. Not able to do anything here. They don't even care about the range racks. There's no point at this point in the game. The melee ones are all that matters, and they do indeed get him. Carl, S4. Both solo and S4 just blinking around each other. 30 to 26. 36, sorry. We look at the graphs again. We see the starter team of Vos take control of the game, but then it flicks back up a little bit. Gold-wise as well, it's the same situation. And the push back out from Artur now in this top lane. 32-36. Troll. It's all about the Troll. It really is at this point of the game. If he can get in there, get the bashes off, get the kills quickly, he's going to be fine. But if the BKB runs out, if he gets himself kited by the PL, then Team Vega, they're going to be in a very, very tricky position. Kuroki continues to build on that Dagon. Level 4 now. Got to get that burst damage. PL, of course, Satanic. Level 2 Diffusal, Butterfly. 3.1k gold as well for Artur. Here we go. Pushing down the mid lane. Ready to jump in. Still has a good amount of time on the double damage. Troll Warlord. Very, very tense moment of this game. And ooh, True Believer. True Believer. Did you put the nighttime to limit the vision there of the Dire? Just to scare them off, and it certainly works. They're not going to want to jump in on the Dazzle. And they're not too sure where the rest of the team is. There's no Dire Observer wards around any of these kind of positions in the lane. The most aggressive one they've got is around the Ancient. So not a lot of vision on the Radiant's half of the map. Now into the jungle. All five of them now. Artur bringing in the Creep Wave on the bottom lane. Can they take another set of racks? Hello, there's a Radiant Observer Ward here. It's going to spot out the Shadow Demon and the Sand King. Looks like Troll's more focused in just pushing the lane in. He's going to have to come back for this. PL straight onto the tier 3. Tier 3 to fall. The racks now open. Clearing it out with the Arc Lightning, clearing it out with the Maelstrom. Now it has been completed into a Mjolnir. We're going to create the illusions here of the PL. And of course, the Shadow Demon's illusions will indeed create more illusions. So it is all good. Illusions for everybody. And it brings them to a safely dispatch of the lane without the lane rising to the high ground and giving the side of Vega vision on who exactly is there ready to pounce. Interestingly enough, 23. Only 2 points of Phantom Rush. This man, he wants to farm, and he certainly has been doing that. 29,000 net worth. Ultimate Orb picked up. Is he going for the Skadi? He is. Second Ultimate Orb in the stash. Picks up the point boost in the orb from the side chop. Oh, in the mid lane, S4. He's getting gone down on, and he will go down. 87 seconds off the map, but he does have buyback if the push is forced out here by Team Vega. Top lane, Artur. He's ready to go for it, and he might try and go for this kill. There is a Shallow Grave available from Dazzle, though, and TT realizes he can't find the kill here. Backs up, goes for the Sigil. In comes the Troll, though. Artur, you need to be careful, my friend. They've got Nightstalk here as well. Mantis starts off the silence. Bashes are coming out. Arteezy. Let's have a listen to that, team chat.
Sound resumed.
Fuck.
I would turn back now, guys.
Yeah, go back.
Jesus Christ.
I'm gonna go for him.
We're all TPing.
Right.
I've been silenced.
Zeus on the right. They have ender damage.
And Snow
have to push out lanes, I think.
But if you kill him, get Zeus. It's really good.
I think I'm
base
up
Zeus. Nice. Is that for everything?
Troll loses all his mana.
Archer, why?
Why what?
Why back? By the way, they can do Russia.
Because I have to push our lanes or we're gonna lose.
Russia on top for sure.
It's fine.
No. Holy shit, they're chasing me. Oh,
I'm tipping, I'm tipping. Fine, for now.
Troll can't come, it doesn't have any mana, I think.
I mean, Troll can be doing Russian, right? It's up for sure.
Oh,
oh he's in base. Let's go do it, one Rilla. He is this time.
Sound muted. There we have it. So, you gotta give it to them. Staying very composed after a pretty bad team fight. And they're keeping their heads and spirits high. Still very aware of the troll, and that seems to be who they're thinking about the most. Every time they're off the map, they're always... It's the troll. They've got to be working out where he is, because he's going to constantly be looking for kills, constantly be looking for action now. 24 levels and 3,800 gold on him. There goes Ref comes out. They know that the Artor, PL, and the 4037 Shadow Demon are here on the bottom lane. Nice Stalker grabs himself a regen. He's got this Ags, BKB, and Jam combination. All in all, make it very hard to catch him out. 2.5k HP. And of course, the 18 armor as well. He's one tanky bastard. Well, we heard them talk about it. They knew that Roshan was up. And so, decided to die. They are going to go for it. And they're going to take it very, very quickly. Radiant, they're heading over. Can they try and take a fight off the back of this? It doesn't look like they will be able to as soon as the Roshan is popped and Aegis is claimed. Radiant, they pop down an observer and they get themselves out just in case the Dire were to head in the jungle and smoke up. The Dire themselves, they're going to play it safe. They're going to back up. Keep it cool. 37 to 35, boys. I'm going to need an update from you lads in chat. Baby Rage or Suka Power? Who is going to take this game? Do we believe in the troll or do we trust in the Artor PL? This kind of seems to be what it's all coming down to at this point. Nina, with the initiation, you're set. Ice Shard's going to be off the point. BKB pot straight away. The troll wants to go in on Carl. He should be able to find this as well. Look at the damage flying out. He does get four-staffed away, though, and that will create the space to get Lina out of here. And that will be the fight over for the time being. We're getting a lot of baby rages in the chat. A lot of people trusting in the Artor PL. I mean, they're pretty much a neck and neck. It all kind of comes down to player performance and how well the hero deals with each other. And on paper, at least, PL should be able to keep the control in the kiting when it comes to a 1v1 engagement with the troll and down to kind of just who can sustain through the fight the longest. But at the same time, if they get the jump on the PL and they're able to bring down Artor, actually there's a fair few superpowers coming now. It's balanced. It's certainly very balanced between these two. And here we go. Literally better than TI4 finals. Doppelganger to the high ground. Onto the tier 3s. The defense. Is it there? Yule's up onto the troll. Pots the peak of it straight away. Now he goes in onto Carl. Carl eats the cheese. It's fine. He's fine. Gets himself four-staffed out. Artor with the doppelganger. Thinking of continuing the fight. BKB the pop by Tusk. There goes your purge through the BKB. Shallowgrave will be there. No one has died yet. It looks like he's going to be fine. The weave from the high ground will be able to keep alive with the shadow wave. And now the massive epicenter there from Kuro. That could be game defining. Brings down Troll. Troll will buy back. Dazzle getting very close to PL Illusion. PL is going to turn his attention to the Night Stalker. Double kill for Artor. In goes solo on the Tusk. Punches up Carl. Nightmare holding the Tusk in place. In comes Night Talker back with a buyback. Artor getting fairly low on the PL. He does, of course, have the Aegis. He will have the Satanic back off cooldown in 6 seconds if he wants to continue to fight. They're two heroes down on the side of Team Vega. And, well, the side of the Team Havos, they just go straight for the Rax. Fortification will come out. Nightmare onto Artur, getting himself more illusions. Blink forward. Burrow strike onto Nightstalker. Nightstalker did buy back for this fight. There's your defusal charge. They will have the shallow grade to buy sometime. Carl there with the yules onto the troll, trying to keep the control. There is your BKB from the troll, trying to man fire up. This is the last chance for the troll, but there we go. The ultimate from the Shadow Demon through the BKB. That will be the fourth kill on the team. There's your team white. Artur finishing with a double kill. The baby rage is real. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not looking good for any of you Faker fanboys out there. Onto the tier fours. This looks like it may just be game. And on that bombshell, let's see what is going on the Dyer's chat.
Sound it's the control. I mean, that's great, but...
I wasn't expecting it. I'm also уже straight away. Because he's straight away from the back on the same place.
It's actually so annoying to play against Nightstalker and Zeus. You guys look free to make